In their submission made to the ad hoc committee instituted to specifically probe into the matter, Hassan Chimbugwe, the director for Opaque Prime Properties, told lawmakers that everything was frustrated by corruption infested within the lands and urban development entities of government.
Again, the same story to happen. If you don't have money in this country, and of course I was dealing with Irish developers, they were like, well, I was like, listen, I need to give some money. They're like, no, we don't do that. We don't even mention that. And obviously because we're unable to do that, that's where we find ourselves here.
Legislators quizzed Opaque Prime Properties of allegations that the firm had no financial ability to deliver on the project.
What it is insinuated or indicated that you actually did not have financial capacity to undertake the project. So
let me finish your phone because you've also interrupted me. And I wanted, because I'll miss my train of thoughts on her.
No, why wouldn't you clarify the principle that of the financial capability?
But now I can't answer
let's
her.
Let's have one
Are you
answer.
With me, Honorable? Now I can't answer her.
There was this belief, not amongst us alone, that Opaque did not have money. I am glad today I'm seeing you for the first time. Yes. This is my third term in Parliament. But we've been asking who is Opaque. Actually, you were as Opaque as the name itself. So today we are seeing you here.
It is for so many mistakes, as we all have done mistakes. But one thing you cannot blame Opaque Prime Properties is their financial ability. And that's, you can blame them everything, you can blame that, but that's the
can
one thing.
Can you be clear? Opaque Prime UK or Opaque Prime Uganda?
For me, it's the same because
It's the same.
Because Opaque Prime UK is owned fully by Opaque Prime Properties. Opaque Prime UK owns Opaque Prime Properties Uganda fully.
Chimbugwe told Parliament that his firm had the ability to deliver on the project but was only sabotaged by silent calls for favors from various offices that he did not disclose.
Not that anyone asked in particular, no one asked in particular, but just for example, just look at this, a settlement agreement signed by the Attorney General. 8 months not being implemented. Some people don't go even through a bidding process. Within a day, the titles are issued. Not that anyone asked me for money, but it's very clear that they have got more favor than us. And if they're using favor doesn't only have to be in money. There could be other influences.
Chimbugwe told MPs that they have since lost interest in the said project and would not wish to ever indulge in any other similar developments with government.
It's no time and money. That, let me tell you one thing, we're willing to forego all that. It had nothing to do with that.
Opaque Properties has asked Parliament to stop the ongoing allocations of Nakawa Naguru land, claiming it's illegal since there is no court order stopping any developments on this land, which was violated.
Of these current allocations are illegal in the sense, one, they were issued in contempt of court, which is a serious illegality, because there was a court order in place and the Attorney General had written to Uganda Land Commission saying that those allocations made in contempt of court order are null and void. Secondly, the allocations of Uganda Land Commission are illegal in the sense that the Uganda Land Commission was not properly constituted. The commissioners there were not appointed by the president, as is the constitution. Commissioners there did not realize the quorum, as is the constitution.
So there have been several attempts to have the administration of the Opaque Prime Properties appear before the same, but this had never happened until yesterday when the officials surfaced at Parliament. Action. Story by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.